In the Orthodox tradition, humility has often been called the mother of all virtues, and pride has been named the cause of all sin. The wise and honest person is the one who is humble. As you listen and meditate to the final podcast in the series, Reverend Father James Cheriyan will be speaking about the topic of humility.
All glory and honor be to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. When prayer is our journey and repentance our path, humility becomes our companion. Or we can also say, humility is the staff for our journey. In the absence of humility, no spiritual labor can yield any fruit at all. And this is the reason why the fathers of the church call humility as the mother of all virtues. How perfect an example Christ himself shows us when he says, "For who is greater? He who sits at the table, or he who serves? Is it not he who sits at the table? Yet I am among you as the one who serves." St. Luke chapter 22, verse 27. St. Gregorios of the desert says, "Be humble so that God guards and strengthens you, because God looks to the humble. Be humble so that God fills you with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, because it is written that he guides the humble and teaches his ways to the meek." And then Pacomio says, "Be humble so that you can be joyful, because joy goes hand in hand with humility." There is an extreme example of humility in the life of Saint Makarios the Great of Egypt. At the beginning of his monastic life, he lived as a hermit just outside a certain village. An unmarried young woman in the village became pregnant, and in order to protect the young man, she accused the hermit, Saint Makarios. The villagers became angry. They ran to his cell, accusing him, humiliating him, parading him through the town, beating him to the point of death. The parents of the girl insisted that Saint Makarios should support the girl. Saint Makarios accepted this as God's will. He said nothing except to tell himself, "Makarios, you have found yourself a wife now. You must work a little more in order to keep her." He worked day and night, making and selling baskets and sending the money to the girl. When it came time for the girl to deliver, she remained in labor for days, unable to give birth. Finally, in great anguish, she admitted that she had falsely accused Saint Makarios. The whole town decided to come to the saint and do penance before him. And that is when he runs away to the desert. He becomes one of the holiest men to live there. The life of humility is always challenging. We are always taught to compete, to grow, to become mightier and more glorified than the other person next to us. Humility can be something very foreign to our minds. Bishop Ignatius in his book titled The Arena, says, "Vainglory feeds on human praise and privileges. It is invented by the mind, and it arises from our fallen state. It feeds on wealth, nobility of birth, race distinctions, and other vain earthly honors. Pride and vainglory find its foundation in false ideas. Anyone free from the sickness is close to salvation, and anyone affected by it is far removed from the glory of the saints. When humility descended into Sheol, Sheol was exalted to the heavens. But when pride entered into the heavens, it brought the angels of heaven to Sheol. All glory and honor be to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever. Amen."